Don't videotape us now.
Too late.
Mr. Blewitt!
Morning.
I think it's more for businesses coming into town, thinking of locating here, what the schools are about.
You don't want this thing to fix it. Keep your head turned, Jenny.
Making a commercial for the schools. Sell our city schools, you know what I mean?
You can turn that on in the back if you want.
Yeah, it's all right. I got what I needed. Maybe you'll be a star.
I can be a star.
Yeah, do your dance. You can go ahead and walk through.
That's true. You guys are late. Is it your fault?
Because you were taking us
there.
They wanted you guys out here. No.
With a chance, what I need you guys to do is to box yourselves up on who's going to be at what tables. Okay? So I mean, like eight over there, however many here, that's where you need to sit in that section. Okay, anybody got any questions? Yeah.
No, no.
These need to be taken out, hang these up on
Mike.
Each side of the thing.
Mike, you're having those on the other table down there.
Okay, what?
Those, keychains or pens.
Nothing's done. Okay, we need to make sure they get down there.
What other tables?
Contracts and pens and all that stuff need to be put down there. That,
they might.
Yeah.
You guys take your pass.
Go ahead, Andy.
Are you getting your tables? You got a table?
No,
okay.
pretty side. We had quite a few last time.
You said 10 to 8, honestly.
And then there was. Go. Shh, quiet.
intervention specialist for the Chillicothe City Schools, and I'll let you explain to everyone that's going to participate in today's program. Okay, I want to welcome everyone here this morning, and the program actually is not being brought to you by me, but it's sponsored by Keen Institute here at school, and also Nationwide Insurance. And we have with us today several guests. I know everyone will be courteous to our guests as they're explaining the Prom Promise program, which is what the assembly today is all about. It's a very serious thing, and as we get into it, I'm sure you'll agree that's a real important assembly and something.
Begins like chin. Look at the calendar, our real calendar. Did that give you a clue? Mark?
I just thought that because my dad's name is Mark.
Oh, sure. I can understand that. Mm-hmm. But this is a wee bit different, isn't it? Sounds as if you're sneezing at the end. Great. Very good. And the last sentence, boys and girls, tells something very important, Bethany. We will have company this afternoon. Remember, Mrs. Steele and Mrs. Miller, when we were watching a couple of other tapes more recently, boys and girls, they mentioned to you that March is a rather winter.
Thank you. Okay, talk them over here and check your work.
So, everyone in?
It's better if you're doing what you're doing.
Right here, and you can start subtracting from there. Thank you. Somebody's moving in. Do you want to go on? Michael, how much did you do? You better.
Oh,
Stephanie.
Look at the picture.
Zach. you need to be here.
No.
Ryan, you need to be here. Okay, she's got her imagination going again, doesn't she? She's thinking about... Wait for one center. Okay, can you come me back when you have to set it up? Jason, do you think that's what people want to see when they put the film for in our classroom? Do you think the public wants to see that? Look at your work, you do.
I'm done, I'm out of here. Wait. Oh my gosh, Sam.
Let me see. I saw yours.
You're done. You're not done.
Worthy by performing a number of impossible tasks.
Hey, I'm over here! Come on!
After mastering every dangerous challenge presented to him, the brave little tailor returns to claim his reward. But in the end, he learns that what one wishes for isn't necessarily what one really wants in this enchanting tale by the Brothers Grimm. The Wolf and the Fox. A thoughtless wolf who can't seem to catch anything to eat forces a clever fox to do his bidding. This makes the fox miserable as the wolf is mean and treats him poorly. Worse yet, the fox must cater to the wolf's empathy.
Thank you.
looks great. That's right, Jennifer, you tell them how to do this.
You have to act natural.
Gotta act natural. Act naturally.
Yeah.
50. I thought
it said 40 over day. Yeah, I thought about that. I was fighting my own.
What day is it, Stu?
How are you doing, everybody?
I thought it was off square. So now you go from here?
Just stand lateral. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yes, lateral. Right here. Go from here.
Now what about this 8x? Okay, you take 5x times 5x is 5.
Let me go full circle, don't you?
Yeah. Well, I don't bear.
Only problem is all I see is hair. There we go.
That is good.
It's gonna be 3x.
Ta-da! Close up.
You're right. So then you bring down.
Now where I go from here? From
here. Wait a minute, I got a thing in there.
And then what do I do now?
You've got to bring that on around, so the one you just stopped on. Yeah, that's right.
X, 3, X.
Just
straight. So I write my 3, plus 3, plus 3. Then I write 3X.
Now you go from what?
3 times 5 is
5. No, then I go from this one here.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
Yay!
Depends which side you're doing, which side you're trying to bisect.
Oh, how do I get this stuff?
Okay, here we go.
No, the answer is x plus 3.
Yeah, right there.
Don't look at me.
My favorite class. I love this class.
I'll go back.
I get the best grades in the whole class.
Me and Joe straight in
the class.
These questions came mostly between classes and during lunch. No classes were described to claims the tinkers after the suspension of students stayed out of school until New Year's, the date they had scheduled for the end of their protest, but they were back coming to school throughout the term and expressed their anti-war
sentiments.
And they decided to take the matter to court.
Students' rights. Today's decision, officially called Tinker versus Des Moines Independent School District, spells out that the First Amendment applies to all citizens regardless of age. You hear that? Who does the First Amendment apply to?
Everybody, no matter what your age is.
That's right, regardless of age. According to Justice A. Portis, students do not lose their rights to freedom of speech at the schoolhouse gate. Portis said that the Des Moines officials had no reason to believe that wearing an armband or cloth not more than 2 inches wide would cause disorder in the school. And the justice pointed out that the officials seemed to be censoring.
Narrow down your eyes towards the bottom here. When you have the fraction, remember we're remaining. What do we have to do with the 5? Andrea? We're going to borrow from it. And why? Have a fraction. So what do we take from the 5? 1.
Okay, there's 69 problems. 23. So how many would we put
23.
On each time?
23.
So let's make 3 columns, go down 1 through 23, 24 down 2, make 3 columns with 23 in each. Please put your name on your paper. Can't forget that. I know you took some of it yesterday. Okay. Well, you sit back there where you were. Please, when you take these boys and girls, keep your eyes on your own papers. Remember, these are practice for what you're going to do next week. I have some answer sheets here for you.
Miss any.
This is Kara. And Mark.
And are you Vanna? Vanna White?
My Vanna White.
No.
A wannabe.
Yep.
A man I want to be.
Well, why we have the tape go? Hi, I'm Miss Renninger. I'm single, looking for the right person. And I want a cherry red Lamborghini because my birthday is April 6th. I'm like white gold, and my class is going to be a party, and they're going to be all the same. Because they love me so much. They also don't want any work. They love that day.
Love you, Miss Renninger.
I will be able to attend your birthday party because I will be at the orthodontist.
Oh. I'll come with her. Oh, ding dong.